Hi there, I'm Sneha and you are watching my channel Book Junction. Welcome to today's video. So the month of September is here and usually September is my favorite month. And the reason is basically because October is my birthday month and then there is Durga Puja. So many things happen in October and September is the month where I can be like officially excited about everything. So that's the reason why September is my favorite. However, because of the coronavirus, I really don't think we will be able to celebrate Durga Puja or anything like we used to. So that's something that's really sad. But I think we should all be grateful if we are still safe, healthy and fit, because so many months have gone by and if we are still safe and we are still fit, I think that is nothing short than a blessing. So that's something we should be grateful about every single day and that's what I'm doing. So that's something I wanted to address before starting this video. Anyway, so from this month of September, I'm going to start practicing a little bit of bookish journaling. That's what I'm going to share with you in this video. But as you know that before sitting down to journal or read, I always make something for myself. So that's what I'm doing. I'm making myself some mosambi juice. And this is a really nice peeling technique that I learned from YouTube. So you can do that. And by the way, I read that this juice is really good for our immunity. By the way, everything is good for our immunity suddenly. So I just grinded it in my mixer grinder and then poured it through a sieve. And this is what we have. I didn't really have rock salt. Otherwise, it tasted good. But with rock salt, it tastes much better. Alright, so now let's start journaling. So first I will make a cover page and first I wanted to go for an autumn theme because, you know, September is all about autumn. But in India, we don't really get to see a lot of autumn scenes in September. I think around November, we get to see a little bit of autumn leaves and all of that. So that's why I just went for purple and pink. Purple is, by the way, my favorite color if you want to know a fact about me. Purple and green are my favorite colors. So first I'll write about the books that I read in the month of August. I think this is a great way to register all the books that you have already read and in which month. Then I'll write my favorite quotes from the books that I've read in the month and then I'll plan my next reads, the books that I'm really looking forward to read, and then some random jibber jabber, you know, you always have something stupid to write. So that's that. So first, I have divided the books that I've read in August in two parts. First, I'll write the non-fiction reads and then I'll write the fiction reads. So in non-fiction, I read Wabi Sabi, Ego is the Enemy, Stillness is the Key, Obstacle is the Way and The Daily Stoic, which I am continuing to September. And in fiction, I read 40 Rules of Love, Red, White and Royal Blue, City of Glass, City of Fallen Angels, and lastly, The Midnight Line, which is a fiction book, it's a thriller. So those were all the reads. I think it was a pretty balanced month. I read both non-fiction and fiction equally. Anyway, so moving forward, now we have the favorite quotes part where I am writing all the favorite quotes from the books that I read. So first, the yellow one is Wabi Sabi, the green one is The Obstacle is the Way, and then the blue one, which I am going to write now, is Ego is the Enemy. And as you can see, I marked so many pages and flagged so many parts, so I really had so many favorites, but first, I'm going through all of them. So I think this is a great practice when you can go through all the quotations that you mark and read them again and then pick your most favorite that resonated with you and that you want to never forget. So that's the one I'm going to write over here. I think this is really an incredible practice. So I'm really going to do this every month from now. And you can also do this, you know. And I have used these colorful pointers or flags, whatsoever you want to call them, because they add a little bit of color and it looks pretty. Of course, it's not a necessity. A lot of people keep commenting that, you know, do we really need all of these things? You'd never need these things. These are just some fancy things that you can want. So there's always a difference between wants and needs, and you are the one who is going to decide what you will need and what you will want. It's completely up to you. So just because you see someone doing something, you don't really have to do that. So it's you who will make the decision. So this is the first page. I did not record the second page because then the video will get really long. Anyway, moving forward, next page was all about planning my next reads, and that's why I'm showing you this, because this book came up and I have been wanting to read this book from so long, and September is going to be the month when I finally read this book. So the book is Digital Minimalism by Cal Newport, and trust me guys, I love the book Deep Work by Cal Newport. I enjoyed that book so much, and I have talked about that book enough on my channel for you to know that I loved it. So when I read the reviews of this book, a lot of people said that this one is even better than Deep Work, and honestly, it just completely drove me crazy, because if this is better than that, then this really has to be amazing. So I'm really excited to read this book, and after I am done reading this book, I will definitely share the lessons with you guys as I always do. So definitely let me know in the comments if you would want to watch a video where I share the lessons from this book with you. Also, I think I really have to mention this, that the book cover is absolutely beautiful. It's so minimal and it goes with the theme of the book so perfectly. So really, thumbs up for the cover of the book. It's beautiful. Alright guys, so that was all for today's video. I really hope that you enjoyed this video and found it valuable. If you did, then definitely like, share and subscribe to my channel. It will mean a lot to me. And you can also follow me on Instagram. I go by the name book_junction. I share a lot of things there as well, so you can follow me there. And I'll see you in my next video. Until then, bye bye.